My name is Tony Thomas, and you're watching Hardwired Exotics on YouTube.
That's a cute pink shirt you got on there.
Is that my pink shirt?
I actually do like your pink shirt.
Yeah.
That's from These Balls.
These Balls.
These Balls. You got a pink hat too? So I like that. Hey, side note, go ahead and look at that cool, luxurious hair you got going on there.
Yeah.
So I was talking to a friend of mine. We were watching the videos at the house while I was cooking the other day. And someone told me at the house that Tony needs to not wear his hat and to let his hair, rock out in some videos.
Yeah.
I've
had it pulled up a couple of times.
Yeah, you need to. You need to rock it out.
It gets in my face and I can't stand it.
You can man bun it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've done the man bun a couple of times.
Yeah. At least you still got hair.
My wife gets on to me all the time about not wearing it up.
You know, you need to wear it up. So what y'all think, guys? If you want to see Tony's hair up, give me a thumbs up. If you want to see him with a hat, give me an emoji of a hat.
Nobody watches this because they want to see me.
They want to see you. That's what they're doing. That's what they're doing.
Anyway.
All right, what are we doing?
So first things first.
What's that? Where'd you go? You're out of the frame. Where'd you go? You just disappeared.
I'm back.
Oh, what's up?
So, got up.
What's that?
Your angle's off.
My angels are right.
There you got go. You some.
Oh, shoot. That's my favorite color.
Yep. I know. You got an orange today. See? I knew what you were wearing today.
How'd you know?
I just good.
You got cameras in my house.
So. Anyway.
What's this?
Arlington Logging. A good friend of mine, Dylan, runs a logging crew with his family. And he gave us some hats. And because I'm such a gentleman, and I know Craig likes orange.
I do. I like orange because I'm wearing a orange hat right now.
Yep.
So let me throw my favorite hat over there, and
you can try that one out.
Try this one. Do I got a flat billet like you do?
However you want to, man. Everybody's
flat billet. Hold that. Fix this.
Look at Craig, boy. He's rocking out today.
You know, I'm not a flat bill kind of guy. I gotta curve that bad boy. Yeah. There we go. What y'all think?
Yeah, Craig looking.
Yeah. Craig. I just need an axe.
There you go.
How we do it? Hey, appreciate you.
Yep. Anyway, set this to the side. Oh yeah, I got one more thing.
What you got?
So,
it is a box.
Bring the rolling card out.
Are we doing an unboxing?
Unboxing. So, you remember that Foch guy we were picking on?
Oh yeah, he's Foching crazy.
Yep. So, he sent me something in the mail.
Did he now? So, I didn't realize Cody Foch was bearded balls.
Bearded balls.
Yeah. Didn't realize he was bearded balls. And
I don't think I want my balls bearded, but
You know, it is what it is, but we're both, you know, bearded breeders. I like that.
I just got my beard trimmed too.
It looks good. It looks good on you. So what you got? It's a hair dryer.
No unboxing of a snake today, but we are unboxing a bullfrog.
A bullfrog.
Yep.
I like bullfrogs.
So,
what does it do?
It is a Bluetooth speaker.
No joke.
Yep.
So, Cody got you a bullfrog.
He did. I think he has a family member that works for Kicker, actually, and Kicker manufactured this. So.
Really?
That's pretty cool.
No, I mean,
give him a big shout out and appreciate.
I'm a fan of that.
I think he's trying to work out a deal on something, and he's trying to butter me up a little bit, maybe. But it ain't gonna happen.
It ain't gonna happen. We don't accept bribes here.
Anyway,
hats and speakers.
That's it. So, but we really do appreciate this. My wife and children will thoroughly enjoy this. I personally like nice and quiet when I'm working, so I can focus on things and get my mind straight. But
that's right.
They love music, so I'm sure they'll enjoy it.
Nothing wrong with that at all. So,
yep, Bearded Balls.
If y'all ain't following him,
hit him up.
Hit him up. He's at Bearded Balls. Cody Punch.
All right, so while I'm packing this back up, you know what? There's no need packing this up.
Why are we packing it up? I mean, we're not going to pack it up. We're going to use it.
It even comes with a charger.
Oh, so that's
directions. Who needs directions?
Nobody. Connect Bluetooth.
Yep.
Hit play. Turn volume on max.
All right, so stick that up there for a second.
Yeah.
So, as people may or may not know, if you follow me on Facebook and Instagram, you probably already know this, but past couple weeks, well, let's just start a couple years ago, started collecting knives. Just I have many different blades, many knives, and we had a bad episode about, what was that? You know what? I'll just say his name, Rye Fry at Fry Knives. January of 2020, maybe. Somewhere like that. I don't remember exactly. Anyway, I sent him close to $300 for a custom-made knife. And that ended up not working out to my favor. The knife that he did send me was honestly just trash. It wasn't finished, wasn't heat treated correctly. It was just a mess. So in that, I actually had a friend of a friend reach out to me and say, "Hey man, sorry to hear what happened to you, but I'm a knife maker and I would like to make that up to you." So I told Rye and his family not to worry about sending me the money, and it was right around Christmas time. And judging by the way that they had responded to it, they needed the money way worse than I did. That being said, this other guy hit me up and said, "You know, what kind of knife are you looking for? I'll be glad to make you one at no charge." So I thought that was really cool of him. I told him no thanks. I wasn't interested in taking people's charity. But if he was interested in making my knife, I would love for him to do it, and I would pay him. So I've paid almost double for this knife that I'm fixing to show you. But anyway, Levi Fringe is a knife maker out in Arizona, and he made me this knife. Boom. Absolutely ridiculously crazy knife here. So this is cable Damascus that he left black. I don't know if you can actually see it in the frame or not.
No, you can.
Mike can see it with a reflection. Anyway, it has my HWE letters in it. These are actually hand cut out of a 50 caliber shell. So pretty cool there. Obviously it's got the blue and all too. Anyway, great feeling knife. Absolutely love this. This is for sure one of my favorites in my whole collection. So anyway, great knife maker. If you ever want anything made, I highly suggest that you hit him up. So really appreciate everything that you've done for us, Levi. And while I was at it, I don't usually buy just one blade from somebody. I always try to buy two, but this is what else I picked up.
There he goes, walking off camera again.
Sorry.
It's all right. Look at that.
So
you got another one?
Yep. Oh. So this was also made by Levi. So
you're not getting in the frame, but not, I'm getting the knife in the frame. That, I'm digging that.
Yep. Again, super light blade. Absolutely love the material that he used on this. Kind of a hybrid with the wood and the epoxy. Great feeling knife. Really like it. So again, appreciate it, Levi. So what I'm getting at is I've met him and I've met a bunch of other knife makers, and the local knife maker that we have here is always, I ain't gonna say always, but for many years been a good friend of mine. I've bought knives from him way before I even started this reptile business. I've known him for a long time. And through meeting all these other knife makers and already knowing him and already having weapons that he's made and knives and blades that he's made, it registered in my head that, hey, maybe you ought to try your hand at making some of them too. And that's exactly what happened. So past couple of weeks, I've been doing a lot of working on handles, making knives, things of that nature. Starting to learn how to forge and drill, you know, all the other stuff, making the handle materials and making the handles, gluing them and pinning them onto the blades. So anyway, I'm trying to work all, learn and work on all of those. We'll have some blades available in the very, very near future, probably before this video even posts. I will have some available. But I wanted to make a YouTube video to explain what's going on. I am an apprentice. I'm working under Mr. John Grooms of Briar Creek Blades in Sylvania, Georgia. Nothing goes out of the shop without his approval. And and he's a great guy. And I just wanted to let everybody out there in YouTube world what was going on. And people that are on Facebook and Instagram, I can now just send them this link and explain to them that I'm apprenticing. I am selling his knives. I am making my own and will have some available soon. But in the meantime, you really, really, really should check his stuff out. Again, some of the best stuff and that I've ever seen. I've had his knives for way, 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 way past before Blair was even born. So I've known him for a long time. Great blades. I'm fishing to show you some. So this is one of Mr. John's knives. This is a custom piece that is made from 1095 steel, which is a high carbon steel. You can see kind of the mirror finish on that, which is people don't know. You see reflection. People don't know high carbon is a more black steel, so to have it shiny takes a lot of polishing. Most of my knives I don't use, I just like to have them, so really cool. So really cool handle material here, but you can see that blade is super straight. Kind of hard to get that on camera.
Yeah, but I got it. I got it.
So anyway, great looking blades, and real happy to own a bunch of these. I have a pile of them in my personal collection. So
I think that's what a lot of people that live in bigger cities, they don't have is like your local craftsman. You know, like,
yeah, there's very few people who live in cities probably have the ability to do things like this because of space.
I mean, just anything, you know, like where I'm from in North Carolina, we have that whole Frogtown place that's nothing but pottery.
Yep.
You know, you miss out on these things being in bigger cities. So, I mean, the rest of the world needs to see this. Yep. This man can make, look at that.
Yep. So this is a Damascus blade here. So majority of the Damascus blades that he makes, well, that really any knife maker makes these days, actually comes from Alabama Damascus. They simply just make a blank, and you put your edge on it, put your handle material on it, and then sell it.
So this wasn't forged and hammered?
No, and The reason why most people don't do this by hand anymore is simply because of time. People do not want to pay $1,000 for a truly Damascus multi. You know, they have to fold this. Damascus steel is actually folded over and over, and that's how you get the pattern.
And that's why they use cable instead, because the cable's multiple pieces. Cable's
already multiple pieces. Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
So it's easier to do a cable Damascus.
Okay.
Than it would be a Damascus like this. So most people do not forge out their own Damascus anymore. Most people will not pay $1,000+ to get a blade such as this, that if you hand forged it from Damascus yourself.
Shoot, I know some people would.
And there are people that will.
Yeah.
And Mr. John does know how to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But that's just the way the knife world works these days. When they have machines that can fold this metal and make this Damascus.
That's right.
And then just cut out the blanks and send them to you, and then you actually shape the blade out of yourself. That's kind of basically how it works. And the etching, you know, the etching that does that brings the carbon out, which is actually what you're seeing is the carbon.
That's a good angle.
The carbon in the blade is actually what you're seeing that gives it that crazy look. And there are a bunch of knife makers that still do it by hand. Props to them. And, you know, like I said, most of your true knife makers know how to do that. I will learn how to do this. I will make one, but making them for resale is nobody wants to pay $1,200 for a custom Damascus blade when the guy down the road sells them for $200-$300.
That's right.
So mass production. I ain't gonna say mass production because it's not really mass production, but just the sheets they're able to make, you know, hundreds of pounds of metal blank Damascuses, you know, in one day that would take a normal human being, you know, a week to to do. So
technology. So we got 14% battery left because someone forgot to charge GoPro. Yeah. So what do y'all think? Should I make another YouTube channel? I'm thinking about calling it Tempering with Tony. And that's just where I film him while he's trying to make things. So, I mean, what? I'm doing Cooking with Craig? Because someone took my OnlyFans name. I mean, that, yeah, I got it on YouTube, but somebody else got it. So what y'all think? Y'all want to see Tony make some knives?
Yeah. We'll see. Like I said,
I think
just starting out. We'll see how well it goes. And I don't know. We'll see how it goes.
I mean, we are going to do an episode where you show me how to paint a car.
Paint a car.
Yep. That's right.
And honestly, speaking of painting a car, the knife making honestly folds back to years in the body shop that I spent, you know, making sure stuff's straight, you know, getting good edges on stuff. I mean, all of this is a lot like body work. So, and a lot of us like painting. I mean, I have to come up with these material colors, things like that. So a lot of this was almost like second nature for me already. So that's why I was able to advance really quickly and within 8 hours, I had already finished a handle out on a knife. So to the point that it was available to be sold. So, you know, there's a good connection there between the automotive industry that I've worked in all my life practically to making blades. So I think it's pretty cool.
I think you'll enjoy it.
I think so. So y'all stay tuned on this new adventure as I go through it.
Yeah.
So
give you something to do as soon as there ain't no money in snakes.
Yeah, there's no money in snakes. I need something else to do.
Need something else to do. Well, all joking aside, that's a gorgeous blade.
Yep. But I really appreciate everybody's support already in this. A lot of my closer friends know what's going on, and we appreciate it. I've sold a lot of knives for Mr. John already, and already have people wanting ours or mine with my signature on it. So anyway, I'm going to quit rambling now and hope y'all enjoy this and stay tuned for, what are we going to do next?
I don't know. We got 11% battery, so.
Nothing today.
B-roll. Lots of B-roll.
Lots of B-roll. We'll see y'all.
See ya.
Thanks for watching Hardwired Exotics, and make sure you subscribe. Bye!